In South Florida, an international art extravaganza is underway once again. It is back. Miami Art Week and Art Basel typically attract large crowds. All of it paused last year, but it's back on this year. VNC's Stephanie Bertini takes us there and has more.
Right now, I'm surrounded by art pieces inside Art Miami, one of several fairs that will be opening up to the public over the next several days here in Miami and on Miami Beach. All of this was interrupted last year because of COVID, but this is typically a time of year where we attract people internationally. Miami Art Week and Art Basel is a way for the local economy to make some money. It's also a way for people to network. It attracts people that are serious about art, including well-established artists, as well as people who just come into town for a good time. It's not unusual to spot celebrities, and it's not unusual for there to be a lot of parties at night. The nightlife is vibrant. Obviously, art pieces are for sale, and some of them super expensive, some of them more affordable and accessible. One thing I love about this time of year is that we see art from across cultures. True diversity is alive and well in Miami and on Miami Beach during this time of year. Again, because it was interrupted last year due to COVID, we are seeing some changes. There's different protocols in place. What we're also seeing is a lot of appreciation that Miami Art Week and Art Basel is back again. Reporting in Miami, I'm Stephanie Bertini. First, start your day.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. Kevin, I always wish I could paint. My whole life, I wanted to know how to draw and everything like that. I just, look at all that art. It looks so great, so vibrant. Yeah. Stephanie always looking vibrant. So, I mean, I love that. I'm glad that it's back. And again, taking those safety protocols and doing what you have to do. But it's just good to get back to some type of normalcy.
Well, Stephanie lost me when she said the art costs a lot of money. I just stick to home goods.